Hello, everyone. This is Cosmos Solutions 8. I'm here with my business partner, John. Say hello, John.
Hey.
Today, we're going to talk about the Google Ads dashboard. So it's confusing, right? Like there's just so many buttons and menus and options. And what's interesting is John, who's probably the smartest Google Ads manager I've ever known in my entire life, you have a really specific way of traversing Google Ads. And I feel like you have like a blueprint in your head. And I was hoping maybe you could like, you know, talk to us like we're total newbies. How is it that you approach, like what's the table of contents? How do you do that?
Awesome. So let me share my screen. This is going to be easier that way. There we go. Okay. So in Google Ads, there's really two big main sections in your mind. Think about like there's two buckets in Google Ads. One has a hierarchy, meaning like kind of top, and then you can go down deeper into more and more details. But the other bucket is kind of like everything else. So when you're talking about something like campaign specificity, like what is this campaign and where are the stats and where are the ads I'm running into it, where are the keywords, what are the search terms, all of those things, those are in bucket A, I would call that, with the campaign hierarchy. Bucket B is like if I have audiences or, you know, kind of the more housekeeping items, like who has access to my account and what are my negative keywords that I have for everything. There's a very little crossover in some very minute sections, but if you think about them like two big major buckets, it really helps you kind of start in your mind thinking about, okay, if I'm looking at performance or anything with a hyper specificity about a specific campaign, you go into the hierarchy campaign. And so let me just kind of share with you what this looks like. Google Ads actually has two main navigations. They have this hamburger menu, which is your dark gray banner, and then you have a light gray banner. And anytime you see this home symbol, this is usually where you're going to land. If you hop into your account, you're going to be on the overview or you're going to be in the campaigns. So that's kind of, if you ever get lost and you're not sure where to go, just look for that little home symbol and that'll kind of bring you right back to the beginning. So it's easy to find your way home. Kind of like a big breadcrumb.
For a second, I'm curious, under the all campaigns, is clicking on campaigns the same thing as clicking on all campaigns, or is all campaigns even actionable?
Yeah, so all campaigns here will deliver you the same thing here.
Got it.
But if you wanted search campaigns, you're going to have the same menu on the right, but now you're under the section of just looking at the search campaigns. If you go back to all campaigns, you'll find all the campaigns and it pulls up all the campaigns here.
So is it redundant inside of campaigns in the light gray? Is there a way to filter by only search campaigns?
Yes. So you can, if you wanted to use filters here.
Got it.
You can do anything you want by filters. I mean, you can even say, give me all my competitive campaigns. So you just type in like campaign. You can either use campaign or campaign name. Campaign is like which campaign you want to, you know, look at. Campaign name is there anything in specific in a campaign you want to see? Say yes, contains, you know, search. And now we have a search campaign called search. But if you apply it, it's just going to pull up that one campaign search. And then this one, dynamic search ads, also has search in the name, so you can filter it by name. Coolest part about this is you actually get two different horizontal rows here that will give you the data. So for this month of May, the filtered campaigns, which is what my filter was applied to, these two here, will give you the total for those two campaigns and then compare that to the account. And the account will also include the filtered campaigns. So you're kind of looking at just a subsection of all of your campaigns this way.
Got it.
And then if you ever want to get rid of that, just click on it and then you'll see this little X, not this X here, but this X right here that will go away. And then you can look at your campaigns that way. Also, inside of like the all campaigns view, you can see all enabled or all but removed. And removed ones can never be re-enabled, but it's a way to see all of them, except for the ones you know that you deleted and you just don't want to look at anymore, because sometimes they'll have data that is incorrect in your skew in your view. Now to get into like the hierarchy of what I mean by that is, if you have a question about the campaign, the ad group, the keyword, the ad, or anything about a specific campaign, that's when the hierarchy starts. And that's kind of that bucket A. If we look at, let's just say the brand campaign, I'm just gonna go very simple. So inside the brand campaign, when you click on that, you'll see on the light navigation, your ad groups automatically get selected because that's the next rung down on the hierarchy. Also on the left-hand side, you'll start to see the ad group inside of that search campaign here. And to give you a quick reference point, whenever you see a magnifying glass as a search campaign, the horizontal and vertical rectangles, this is a display campaign. And if you see this kind of like, you know, tag right there, that's a shopping campaign. And if you see a little movie camera, that's a video campaign. So it's a way to kind of quickly indicate which ones you want to look at. Now inside the ad groups, you'll have, you know, however many ad groups that you would like to have. And if you click on that ad group, you're going to go into the keywords. So now we've gone from campaign to ad group and keyword. And then from here, this is kind of the last section of the hierarchy. But what you can do is now that you're down to this level, think about it like I went to the campaigns, I looked at an ad group, and now that I'm inside that ad group, I can see the keywords. Now, what are the keywords that are spawning what type of ad? So up here, you'll want to click on as an extension. And then inside there, then you'll see the three ads that we have here. And inside there, as an extension, now you have the extensions that are going to be attached to those ads. So you always want to think about, like, you can kind of fall down vertically, down like a rabbit hole of a campaign. But when you're only looking at the campaign, everything you do in this, the vertical light menu, the light gray menu, if you're inside of a campaign, all of these are only about that campaign. So that's what's kind of cool.
If there was another, so I'm looking at the brand campaign there, and under the brand campaign, I know this is blurred out, but there's a specific campaign name. Mm-hmm. Call it campaign A. If there was a campaign B, then that would be highlighted and mm-hmm. everything in the light gray would be applicable to campaign B.
Right. Yep. So you'll be able to see if you're in a specific campaign, everything in this light gray menu, like landing pages, keywords, audiences, demographics, locations, all of that is around whatever is selected on the dark gray menu. So it's kind of like a, you know, where's your main navigation? And then in the main navigation, where do you want to go from there? And then all of that, think of it like a hierarchy of steps down. And the further you go, the more detailed and the more minute that you'll end up in the bottom. So what's kind of nice about this though is if you ever want to take like an isolated look at something and say, you know, maybe how are my ads doing? Well, then you ask yourself, well, we have lots of ads. If we look at just, you know, without selecting a campaign and we look at ad, we have for this one client 143 ads. So what campaign do you want to look at? Okay, well, let's look at a search campaign. Great. Now in the search campaign, let's say for competitors, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, we have 5 different ad groups. Is there a specific competitive ad group that you want to see the ads for? So you have to kind of know what you want to look at with a hyper amount of specificity before you can really take a look at that. If you just say, how's my ad campaign working? Well, we have 10 campaigns, 143 ads. I'm not sure where to start. So you have to know that hierarchy before you can drill down and say, okay, now this is what I want to look at.
I noticed earlier to talk to us a little bit about, you went to the heading menu instead of back to the homepage menu. So
up here?
Yeah. And explain why you did that.
Yeah. So this one is the same thing as going with all to go here, all campaigns. But the difference is when you click on all campaigns here, you clear out the light gray menu here at the same time. So it's like a breadcrumb back to all of the campaigns. So
quick card reset.
Yeah. So instead of clicking all campaigns and then scrolling up and then clicking on the home button, if you click on the breadcrumbs here up at the top, this will just bring you right back to your home.
Can I just make a comment?
Yeah.
On the previous screen, it said optimization score 58%.
Yes.
One of the highest performing campaigns in Google's existence. And they're like, pretend that we're not, you know what I mean? Like, it's so funny when you see the recommended.
Yeah. Well, that's funny is this recommendation score, I can increase it by 25% if we wanted to go after additional competitors. Strategically, that might not be a good idea, but I can go from a 58 up to a, 83. If I just wanted to add more competitors. But the client's like, no, don't go after those competitors. That's a bad idea. Well, then my optimization score doesn't look that great. And then also, if I include keywords in my ad text, then I can get another 16%. But that would mean that I'd be using my competitor's name in my ad copy, which is, that's just not a good idea. You don't want to be like, hey, we're better than them. You want to present yourself as a very good brand. So you can a lot of times ignore recommendation just because the strategy that you're running may not be right. The recommendations are usually for kind of like a broad campaign. Like, just make sure you have all the keywords and all the ads and all the everything and you'll be good. But sometimes you don't want all the everything.
That's awesome. So this is making a lot of sense. You've got your primary menu, you've got your submenu. Within your submenu is the detail. So it goes navigation, information, details. Mm-hmm. And that's bucket one, right? That's mm-hmm. like, what's bucket two? You referenced bucket two, or are we not done with bucket one?
No, we could be done with bucket one, because I mean, then we'd be going into every single one of these subsections here, like what locations are targeting, you have any topics that you're going after, what your ad schedule is, what devices are running, be it computer, tablet, phone, whatever it may be. So again, that's kind of the gist of it. That's how you want to navigate when it's relevant to a campaign. Bucket B is going to be the everything else. And that's usually found up here in the tools and settings. Now, surprisingly, not a lot of people know that this exists. Tools and settings is like the other 50% of Google Ads. From there, you'll have things like linked accounts. I can link my Google Search Console to see how my targeted keywords are competing against my organic keywords. I can link my YouTube channel so I can run YouTube ads and get good data about that. You can actually run YouTube without linking it, but they won't give you much data, so it's always good to link it. Linking your analytics to see bounce rate, time on page, the pages per session, those things. That's just all in this one linked accounts here. Measurement conversions. You want to set up your conversions in this menu here. This goes against all campaigns. Same with linked accounts. Any link account is going to work for every campaign. All of your conversion actions going to work for every campaign. Attribution is going to work for all of your campaigns, seeing how many times a person had to interact with an ad before they converted. Bulk action, these are like little pieces of automation that you get to put into a campaign. Like rules, for example, if my one keyword has a less than 80% search impression share, means a less than 80% market penetration, up the bid, you know, 15% per day, you know, whatever it may be. You can set little rules like if then, then that sequences inside of here. This is actually what a lot of like people that are using third-party tools to bolt onto your campaign to make sure it works. It's basically just a preset you know, grab bag of rules. And then they just believe that this is going to work for everyone, and it really just doesn't. Scripts, way too detailed to get into this. Things like making sure that we can bypass our own authentication so we can, yeah, it's a lot of stuff here. Uploads, this is kind of cool. You can actually upload different conversion actions. You can upload different, if you're building in Google Ads Editor, you can upload it into Google Campaign when you're done building it offline. Other things like this, like really cool stuff, like Audience Manager. This one's really, really good to know. If you're familiar with Facebook, you can use Audience Manager to build in new audiences to be used with Google Ads, whether it's don't show ads to these people or show more ads to these people, or create a lookalike audience, which is called a similar audience in Google. Create a lookalike audience of these, then put these ads to these people. So you can build audiences inside of Google Ads just like how you would in Facebook. And you can do it many different ways. People who visit your website, people who use your mobile app, people that are subscribed or watch your YouTube videos, customers. You can upload a list of your customers or a custom combination of any of them. Like for example, site visitors. From here, you can say visitors of a page who also visit another page. So looked at my homepage and my contact page and pre-filled that list. So really cool stuff in here. Bid strategies, negative keyword list. This is really important. You usually want to add your negative keyword list at the account level, not the campaign level. For example, if I have a company called Washington.com and people type in George Washington, I know I never want to have that on any campaign I ever run, so I'm going to add to the master negative keyword list so that any new campaign in the future, I don't have to worry about it. I'm automatically just going to be blocking the word George.
How many ads managers do you think don't even know that exists, that you can add negative keywords on an account level?
7 out of 10 campaigns we take on add negative keywords at the campaign level. And then what's funny is I'll check the next campaign and they didn't add that to the next campaign and they're wondering why it keeps showing up and they can't turn it off because they added it as a negative campaign. So I'd say it's about 70% of them. Share budgets are really cool. You can give $100 a day to 3 campaigns and just see which one wins. Location groups, placement exclusion lists. So I don't want my ads to be shown on mobile apps because I think kids play those too much and I don't want kids clicking on my ad. Performance planner. This is like the keyword planner, performance planner. This is basically just see if I was to run this campaign, how would it perform? And so planning. So this is a whole other section of Google Ads. And this is used just as much as bucket A of the actual campaign itself. So this kind of like supports everything that you're doing in your campaign. You pull from all of these other menus into your campaign. So that's kind of how those two sections work.
A little redundant. Negative keywords are redundant, budgets are redundant, bid strategy is redundant. So why, is it always the campaign level is just when you want to go specific account level is when you just want broad reaching rules?
Yeah, and there's a good reason for that. Let's say I want to run two different campaigns. My one campaign is going after the keyword fast car. The other campaign is going after the keyword fast car wheels. Completely, you know, separate. Now one's looking for cars, one looking for wheels. Those are two campaigns. I will add the negative keyword of wheels to the fast car campaign so that if they type in fast car wheels, I automatically will go to one campaign and not the other one. I want to apply it to one and I want to exclude it from the other one. if I put wheels inside of my shared library, one campaign would just never run. So sometimes you want to have specific, and that was a horrible analogy, by the way, fast car.
No, that actually made a lot of sense. But like, for example, why would you want an account level bid strategy? Wouldn't you always want your bid strategy to be campaign level?
Well, what's nice about this is you can actually build a portfolio of this, and portfolios are actually going to be something that you can use for multiple campaigns. So for example, if I have a portfolio bid strategy, and this bid strategy is using maximized conversions on the contact us form, that I'm going after a very specific type of action, and I'm only going to use that in like my bottom of the funnel campaigns. So my search campaigns, my remarketing campaigns, I'm only trying to get that conversion action, and maximized conversions work really well. But on my new campaign, I want to use maximized clicks. And so I won't use my portfolio bid strategy that I pre-built and said, this one works, and apply it to each new A-B test of the campaign that I have running. So it's, I don't have to rebuild that bid strategy again.
So if you make a change on the campaign level, it will overwrite the account level.
No. So if you actually make a change in the campaign level, that is actually coming from the account level. I guess it depends. Bid strategy will say, would you like to use your account level or your campaign level?
That was my question. So on a campaign level, you can choose whether or not you use the default. So the account level is the default baseline. Hey, use all these unless, and then the campaign level, you can choose to change it.
Yeah, or actually just more like makes it available. Like, would you like to use the one you pre-built or a brand new one? I'll choose the one I pre-built. And then just, you know, you can switch between those two of them. And same with like shared budgets. Shared budgets, you have to go in here and actually create a shared budget. And then once you call the budget name, like this one might be product A. Maybe I have three campaigns about product A, and I want to use $150 and add the campaigns. And that's going to give me a list to say, I'll add to this, this, and that. And now all three of these campaigns are going to use $150 a day because these three campaigns are all trying to sell product A. One's a display, one's a YouTube, and one's a search, whatever it may be. And so it was nice about that. And then what's funny is if you apply this strategy, even if you're in the campaign, you can't then override the account settings. You have to go back to the shared budget and then like manually remove it.
So if you don't know it's there, you don't know to change your bid strategy.
Right. So there's a lot of times where it's like, hey, people call us and say, I can't get my bid strategy removed. And then they just don't know about this. Oh, it's in tools and settings, not in the actual campaign that you're looking at.
That's amazing to me, because if I were to guess, I would tell you that 50% of professional Google Ads managers don't know the tools and settings section is used for management.
Yeah. And it's really like, you know, it's building the framework of everything that you want to run. I want to have a new audience. I want to put on a shared budget. I want to make sure they both don't go after this keyword or both don't show ads if this keyword was searched. You know, I want to also set the rules that apply to, you know, making sure I have at least 80% search refresh share every day, whatever it may be. Those are all done in the tools and settings. And then you build the campaign and then just apply everything that you build outside. So that's why like there's that two big main sections here, the campaign section here and everything on the middle of the left is all very, very straightforward. Like kind of a yes or no answer. Do you want this campaign? Do you want to look at this campaign? Yes or no. Do you want to look at that ad group? Yes or no. Do you want to look at those keywords? Yes or no. Do you want to look at those ads? Yes or no. Very binary and hierarchy driven. The tools and settings is where everything else is kind of structurally built to support those.
This is really helpful, man. I appreciate you doing this.
Yeah.
Awesome. We're going to do these videos as often as we can. So check back, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. You know how the internet works. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks, y'all.
Thanks.